Hey everyone, and welcome to Comic Breakdown. If you're new to the page, be sure to give us a like and a sub so you don't miss any of the content we have coming out. And today we're going to be diving into Empire's Fantastic Four. So this will be issue number 23 of the Fantastic Four series, tying into the Empire events currently going on with Marvel. Now, if you guys haven't been keeping up with this series, I'll leave a link both in the description and at the top of this video, so you guys can check that out and get completely caught up on everything Empire related. Now, on our previous issue, the Fantastic Four kids, Spider-Man and Wolverine, had formed a little Fantastic Four team. And the Kree and the Skrull children that they had with them that they were tasked with protecting were kidnapped by the Kitati. Now, we don't really understand to what end at this point, but now our Fantastic Four team is looking for them. And without further ado, let's dive into this issue. So diving into this issue, we pick up in New York, and the Kitati and the Kree and the Skrull are just having an all-out urban jungle warfare all over the city. And this is when we see our Fantastic Four team come crashing in. And they talk to some of the Kree and the Skrull, and they ask them if they've seen Joe Vinn, which is the young boy that they've been looking for. And they refer to him as the Chronicle of Blood. So essentially, he's a living memory of the entire war between the Kree and the Skrull, as well as his counterpart. She is also the same. But they do get a clue of where the Priests of Pama are. And so, if we remember, these guys were essentially like human alkalites and assassins for the Celestial Messiah. And so they head off to track down where these guys have been and what they're doing. And they brought them to a facility called Chemmax. And the Kitati had broken in, and they had stolen a bunch of different things. And so we see Val trying to figure out what it was, like why they would need to do this. And this is where we cut over to the Kitati, and they've created a Omni Wave Projector. Now, the purpose of this wave projector, as we saw in the issue of Fantastic Four and the Avengers issue number 6 that came out today, they're using this to be able to get into the mind of every Kree warrior for miles around. And the point of this is to cause dismay between the ranks and have them fighting with each other and not the Kitati. And what better way to do that than to use the Chronicle of Blood? You know, he's got a millennia of hatred in his head, so they just teleport all of his thoughts into everybody's head, and now you have widespread pandemonium. Now we pick up with Franklin and Wolverine, and they're having a discussion on the rooftop as they try to triangulate where these individuals could have gone. And Franklin really just feels like he let everyone down. Like, his only job was to protect these kids, and even that, he failed at. All while his father and the rest of his family are out fighting the big war. And so they finally get like a idea of where they could be, and they start tracking them down, and they head out. All while our young Kree boy is just being used as essentially an energy source for this. And at the same time, they're capturing his counterpart. So now they have both Kree and Skrull Girl. And so now they'll be able to tap into the minds of not just the Kree, but the Skrull as well, and just cause mass panic between the two ranks. And this is when our Fantastic Four team jumps in, but they're already too late to stop the dismay. It's already breaking out between the ranks all over, from Wakanda to New York to the Alliance Command Ship. And while Wolverine and Spider-Man are fighting off the Kitati, Val and Franklin go over to the Kree and Skrull Boy, and they let them know, like you guys have to focus on something else. Like, to break out of this, to be able to overcome this, you have to fight for something that you remember. So fight for each other. You know, you've been put against each other in the fighting pits for so long, you only know each other. And you come to a point where they have such a respect and love for each other. And this is where we see the two be able to break free of this. And all the forces around the world are stopping their conflict. They're stopping fighting and going back to fighting the Kitati. And the Celestial Messiah, very upset that this plan didn't work out, he turns all of the alkalites into trees. And then we see our heroes freeing the two kids. And this Fantastic Four team has done their part for the big war. And that will be where this issue ends. Let me know what you guys think about this. This ties directly into issue number 6 of Empire, the Fantastic Four Avengers crossover. And this really did play a vital part. You know, the forces were going at each other all over and nobody really understood what was going on. So, you know, this Fantastic Four, these kids, they really did come through and play their part in a very significant way. I'm really excited to see what Fantastic Four has moving forward. There's the Fantastic Four Aftermath, and then issue number 24 is jumping into a completely new story arc that we might be covering. Let me know if you guys want me to cover continue Fantastic Four. If it's worth your guys' time, if it's worth my time, let me know. And if you guys haven't yet, be sure to like and subscribe to the page. And until the next video.